All right, so here we are again with beginning beekeeping in Texas. It is an 80 degree day here. I believe it is Thursday, February 17th, but a very mild day. So I decided to swap my brood boxes. So I don't know if you can see down there. The girls are flying, as you would hope. I don't see any pollen yet, but that's not far away. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna take this top box and go to the bottom. So easy situation. Strength of the hive, and see what's going on. So we have a couple winter losses up here, just never really made it back down into their hive. Maybe the first light they've seen. So they might actually be all up in this super up here. I sure hope not. I need to get them going. They're losing light here. So they're definitely active. Checking me out. So hello to the world, little girl. Hello, world. Okay, go ahead and go flying. Oh, I did forget to put my gloves on. So
I've got black on here, and they really, really don't like black. So, just to kind of save them, because I don't want 50 or 60 of them dying on my gloves that made it through winter. What a ridiculous way to die, right? Put these gloves on. Hopefully not tear them as I do so. No more black. But you still have the protection. I've done it with just neoprene gloves and they will sting through them. These are 5 mil, I think. I've seen 8 mil, I think, like mechanics gloves, but like tattooing gloves, but they're all black. So it kind of defeats the purpose, doesn't it? Okay. I think I've seen 8 mil, I think, like mechanics gloves, but like tattooing gloves, but they're all black. So it kind of defeats the purpose, doesn't it? Okay. I may have hit record a little too early, but it's okay. I can edit all these goodies out. You never know. Maybe you want to learn how to light a smoker. These little chef's torches are awesome. Great tools. You want to do this on top of one of your calmer hives. Just in case you accidentally bump something or hit something, they're not gonna get all pissy and come after you. This hive, it will. So we're gonna gently set that on there. You can see we got some smoke. Put some more in to kind of half smother it. Give us some cool smoke. That's enough for now. Thank you. like I said, it is 80 degrees, so I'm not worried about chilling brood. I'm not worried about, it may not even be brood yet. It's warm smoke, but you know what? It'll do. That'll do, pig. That'll do. Okay. Let's try it without smoke. Let's see how pissy they are. You ready? So first of all, let's see where they are. They're all up in the, oh, see, this top is super light. So if they're all up in the top, I might shake them down to the lower ones here. Queen might be in there, so we have to be careful. They are getting a little bit active. Of letting the box go. Not something you want to do because it will repropolize. Oh, this one is full of honey. Once again, your queen might still be in there. Okay, so they're still in the bottom. They're in the top box. By which, I mean this medium or this deep. Actually a little bit of everywhere, but you can see how light this one is. I mean, it's just moving by itself almost. I have my camera facing the wrong way. I'm gonna knock some of this bridge comb out. Still be careful. So we're gonna take this one off. It's so light. Oh, that's one. Okay, so we need to move this off again. So it's not doing a cantilever action there. Am I safe to move this now? Yes. This one off. Being careful not to bang them around. Got some leaves in here. Don't need leaves. Don't want to kill anybody, but we don't need leaves. Okay. Now we just put it back together. So this will go on the bottom. Had some rearranging of frames here. And they are going to clean up whatever comb they don't want, where they don't want it. They're going to clean it all up. So don't worry about that too much. What we will worry about is frame spacing. The hive cover. Both sides of the hives are trying to come off. So we
want all these frames to be in the middle. Looks good. Let's take some of this off. A little brittle there. So they're just checking me out. They're not really being aggressive. They're not stinging. I don't smell banana candy.
Let's just, I'm curious. We all know what curiosity does, right? So they still have honey. Oh, see the girls with pollen on their sacks? They are bringing in pollen. And they're depositing it on the outside frames like you would hope. See? See that? This is where they just unpack pollen into those frames. That is what you want to see. So they're going to start rearing brood any time now. Be really careful. Put this back in.
I see lots of pollen and sacks. Do an extremely compulsory inspection. Oh, I see lots of honey.
Look at that. Oh, an entire frame of honey. Well, I will leave this for them. This is their honey. For now. There's still winter yet to come, so I am not going to...
I'm not going to take that away. That would be foolhardy. Because they're going to get active. They're going to start flying around. And they need energy to do so. This was actually one of my maybe hives. So this is the bottom of what used to be. Oops. That other one. Very light. You do it. So the bottom is the top, top is the bottom, and now they will start here and move up into here. They're going to move all this honey from here up, fly, my pitties, fly. Ah, yes. One other thing I'm going to do. Give them some patty of pollen.
Not a lot. There's some. I don't want to encourage small hive beetles. So just give them little squares. Like so. It's okay if it falls down in there a little bit. Since they're starting to bring in pollen, I probably won't need this for very long, but it's always good to start them off early with a little pick-me-up. See? They like it. Alright, so that's it. Close this up. You should be able to eat all of that. On the next one. So I got four more to go. I'm not going to film those. This one went pretty well. So thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. We'll see you hopefully in spring. Thanks a lot.